Well, it's a great day to go for a run. Wherever you may be, check out the snow. One of many times we have had snow this winter. Last winter, man, we didn't get hardly any snow. Not like this anyway. But thanks for coming back to my channel, guys. It's WV Running Dawn here, and today I'm running a tempo run. 2-minute warm-up, 15-minute tempo, 2-minute recovery. It says jog, but I'm kind of walking now because the snow is taking a break in the snow. That's good for you. These are my tracks. Here are my tracks in the snow. All mine. Fresh tracks. Well, I'm going to do my second tempo here in just a minute. 15 minutes, I'm going to go head up the trail. And then from there, I'll head back home for the cool down. Might have about 7 or so, 8 maybe, I don't know, something like that. Just want to go with whatever my 15 minutes gives me. So here we go. Got a few more seconds left. 15 seconds left in the cool down. There's the view. How much snow do you have where you live? Are you getting a big snowstorm? Are you having rain? What's going on? Had some action here after the last clip through this way. Well, I did my 15-minute tempo and did my cool down, and then I started running again slower, so the actual mile cool down, 2 miles, it'll be about 3 actually by the time I get home. Cool down on the way home, and now I'm going to look at the data on my apps and compare, not compare, but I'll look at the data on my apps and analyze this tempo run to see how I did with pace and heart rate and that kind of stuff. So I'm gonna finish this up and then we'll be back at the house soon. Okay, so that's 8.13 miles in 1 hour and 23 minutes. Not sure what the pace was, I don't remember, but I'm going to put some pictures together from probably from Garmin, overlay some of the information and analyze it for you guys, put it on the screen so you can see. So here we go. Right now I gotta go get dinner.
Okay, here we have the full picture of my tempo run. I had I'd went 8.13 miles in 1 hour 28 minutes with an average pace of 10:54, elevation gain 582. And there's the little route that I have. I went from my house to Mannington and then back to my house on the rail trail. Now here's the pace chart. Now the first 2 miles are just me doing my warm-up, and I did extend the warm-up to like 2.5 miles only because I was at a, after 2 miles, I ran into a portion of the trail behind the Rainbow Plaza where all that mud and water and stuff is at. So once I got across that, I did start doing my first 15 minutes of tempo running. And that kind of reflects itself into the fourth mile, because I went from, once I got to the senior center, I ran around the loop there a few times. I finished my first tempo run, and then I did my 2 minutes of cool down, but then I also did extra time because I was at a portion of the the loop around the senior center where I wasn't able to just take off running. So I waited until I got back to a point where I can get onto the trail. And that's where the mile five comes in. And that starts my second portion of my second 15-minute part of my tempo run. So I ran that, and that put me up to almost to the up the North View, a little bit past North View, or less. No, it put me almost up to around City Hall, and then I turned around and went back, only because I knew if I kept going that I was going to end up with like 9 or 10 miles because of the way that I had done the loops around the senior center already. So then I went back toward the senior center, and once I got back to the senior center, I think I was at probably around 5.5 miles. So from there on, I continued down the trail. Then I did my 2 minutes of walking for my rest time, and then I did my filming for the second portion of the video, and then I finished off the rest of the trail by doing the cool down all the way back to the house. So that's where I ended up with the full 8.13 miles, as it says here. So that's why some of those numbers are, they're kind of at different places, but the 8.49 was definitely at a point where I was doing my full tempo run. This is my pace. Now all those dark spaces are when I was walking on the trail because I couldn't run. And the larger blocks are the spaces where I was walking in between my before I did my tempo, and then in between the tempo, and then after the tempo, where I was doing my 2 minutes of walking, because I was taking my time there so I could rest. Now, if you see, my first tempo run started around 28 minutes, and then I did a full 15 minutes of tempos, and my pace was actually mostly in the sub 9 minutes, mostly in the 8.20s, somewhere in there, 8.20s, and every once in a while I got a little quicker and I had to slow down. But then at 40 minutes, I finished my first tempo run, and then I did my 2 minutes of cool down, and then I started my next tempo run about 43 minutes, and then again, I tried to stay under 9 minutes, mostly in the 8.30s and so in that area. And then at 59 minutes, I was able to slow down and do my recovery run. And then at that point, I was on my way back to the senior center and went through the trail, or went through past the senior center and through the trail. And then I did my video commentary that I was talking into the video there. And then the rest of it, about 1 hour 9 minutes, it was me running on the trail back and back to home. And then I was able to get back home at, you know, at the time of 1 hour and 28 minutes. So that's how it is for the pace. Now here we see the heart rate, and the heart rate, it goes in line with everything else, with the, you know, the low spots are where I started walking, and then the higher spots are where I was doing my tempo. And then the highest heart rate here, I think it was around 190 something, I think, or in the upper 180s, I think. But and then I did my the running on the trail until I got home, and then it was still, average heart rate was near up in the 150s, I think. Now cadence is about the same thing. Cadence, the red is the lowest, and of course the red, the down low red, that's where I was slowing down to do my filming or walking for my recovery during the normal for the tempo runs. Elevation, really, it really doesn't have much to do with anything here, except that with the elevation, I did purposely put the try to do the tempo runs in a time when I was on the trail, where it was flat. So that lowest part of the elevation, that is where I did most of my most of my tempo running. So in the higher elevations, when I was going to the senior center and coming back, that was me just relaxing and taking it easy doing either the warm-up or the recoveries or the cool downs. The heart rate thing here, I don't pay a whole lot to the heart rate, but I try to I pay attention to it when I stop and when I look at it every once in a while, because I know when I'm going fast or when I'm slowing down. But for a tempo run, I would expect probably to be more in the zone 4 and zone 5 area, and not instead of an easy run like a long run. I would expect long runs to be more in zone 4 or even 3, not so much in zone 5, because you're not the one to go real fast in those areas. Now here, I'm just putting my pace. It's my pace over top of everything else. Of course, the heart rate here, heart rate's lower when I was walking, and then of course when I'm doing my tempo run, the heart rate is building and going higher. I was trying not to go too fast, trying to keep things at the same pace when I was doing my tempo, and looks like it still continued up. But with, I did better in the second one than I did in the first one. But then with the cool down, I think that's where I really did a better job of getting my heart rate down lower. Cadence is the same way. The red is in the middle of the places where I was either doing my recovery or doing my walking because of the trail, the conditions of the trail. So that's the cadence. Now here's the elevation I was talking about. The warm-up and cool-downs are kind of opposite of each other as far as pace and elevation. But it's that section in the middle where I did my first tempo run, where I had the first tempo run started on the trail and finished at the senior center. And then the second one started at the senior center and then went up the trail and then back to the senior center. So that center section there of elevation, I purposely was putting the tempo runs on that section where the trail was the flattest. Now that's kind of the best way I could analyze my tempo run. And it's the first time me actually looking through all the information. I look at it, but I don't really pay much attention to it. But if you guys have any other ideas of what I can do to make the information better, or how I can change my running style to make it better for me as far as pace and heart rate with the working with the elevation and stuff like that, if you do, let me know in the comments below. But here's some clips from my running today. It was still another fluffy running day in the snow. Some places were fluffy, some places were packed snow. It's starting to melt. Temperatures were about in the 30s today, so the snow's starting to melt, but I think we're getting more snow tonight, so we'll know how it's going to go for tomorrow's long run. But don't forget to like the video, comment below if you have some advice for me, and share if you think somebody would like to know more about the EHQ 12-hour run or the higher running 50-mile ultramarathon training plan. Other than that, guys, thanks for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, and don't forget to come back so you can see me in the next one.